However, the destruction of the doomed train required an elaborate miniature set overseen by John Sturber.
We had to actually go down and measure every square inch of the trains they had on first unit, and that's how we constructed our trains. We had to match completely, almost every square inch.
Sturber's crew built 5 exact replica subway car models to be destroyed on a 120-foot length of miniature train track. As construction of the 1/8 scale models was underway, another part of the effects team was busy visualizing how the scene would be filmed. In one early test, a cardboard cutout in the shape of a subway car was placed on a length of miniature railroad track. This showed the filmmakers where the best camera placement would be when film finally rolled. Sturber's team also conducted tests to make sure the explosions wouldn't be too bright and blind the camera, or look too large in relation to the miniatures.
And action.
The subway cars were filmed with a special camera rig that followed on a separate set of miniature wheels. Both camera and subway cars were pulled along by a wire hidden underneath the track. Sturber rigged the interior of the tiny subway cars with a potent cocktail of volatile chemicals.
We had gasoline. We had some special mixes that we kind of produce ourselves to give it some different colors. And it's very detailed explosions.
The explosive charges were detonated by tiny trip switches hidden along the tracks, providing catastrophic results.
To see them destroyed at the end, if it's spectacular on film, it's wonderful. It's like building that huge sandcastle on the beach with all your buddies, and then at the end of the day, everybody jump on it and destroy it. It's that great feeling, especially if it's captured right on film.
Subways weren't the only settings the filmmakers had to recreate to accomplish their scenes of devastation. In the film's finale, Schwarzenegger confronts his nemesis, the Devil, inside a Manhattan cathedral. The setup shots for this scene were filmed inside an actual sanctuary, but the script then called for the church to be torn apart in the battle. The solution to this problem was to again build a miniature. But with so many key shots of Schwarzenegger filmed inside the real church, the miniature that was destroyed needed to be a spot-on replica, or the illusion would fail. For that task, the effects team turned to master model makers Ian Hunter and Matthew Gratzner.
This was an existing piece of architecture, so it was very important to make the details match and to be as highly detailed as possible, so that when the miniature is being photographed, there's no question whether it was the real church or a model. It was, you know, completely seamless.
The Hunter-Gratzner team fabricated tiny pews, columns, and lighting fixtures for their 1/6 scaled cathedral. The end result was a 45-foot-long, 20-foot-high reproduction of the actual church used for Schwarzenegger's live-action shots. To break the stained glass windows in sequence, compressed air cylinders were positioned outside the set. The leaded glass was pre-cut so that the blasted fragments would be properly sized.
Okay, everybody stays clear until we get the all-clear, please.
A 6-foot-tall replica of the cathedral's dome was hoisted atop the miniature. And like the windows, pre-cut so it would fall apart on cue.
One shot, walk away.
To create a violent, wood-shattering shot of the church's pews coming unhinged, the Hunter-Gratzner team devised an ingenious piece of machinery. A small trolley was attached to a steel track hidden under the miniature set's floorboards. Lightweight wooden pews were then fastened to a flexible flooring, allowing the trolley to pass underneath the pews, producing this eerie ripple effect. In the midst of all this clatter, the script called for a giant beast from hell to burst through the church's floor. For this chilling sequence, visual effects supervisor Durst started with the church miniature.
We're able to score the floor and through mechanics, burst it up. And we had this green shape, which we call the green Gumby, which simulated the shape of the beast.
To replace the green battering ram with the beast, Durst turned to animators at design house Rhythm and Hughes, led by John Desjardins.
In this movie, every single scene was a huge moment. The scene where the creature burst through the floor in the cathedral. Well, that's a short scene, but it's a huge setup to get that creature looking really nicely detailed for all the close-up work it was going to need.
In addition to a hideous devil, animated flames were generated to add a fire and brimstone effect. All of these elements were combined to produce a groundbreaking scene straight from a hellish apocalyptic nightmare.
God, help me.
Sometimes to spend months on a miniature and then in one quick second blow it up and it's gone. But when you capture it on film, that's where it lives forever.
The spectacle of mass destruction never fails to grab an audience, thanks to the efforts of Hollywood's effects wizards who create movie mayhem.